Still no sign tonight of a missing Peninsula man with dementia. John Houseworth was reported missing last week after he apparently wandered away from his Monterey home. Search crews from local agencies and state and federal agencies scoured the Peninsula last week trying to find him, and they were not successful. Search for Houseworth has been suspended. The formal search has been suspended by police and was so on Saturday. In fact, more than 5 million people in the U.S. suffer from dementia, Alzheimer's, and other brain disorders. The National Alzheimer's Association says nearly half of them at some point wander away from their care providers. But the Monterey County Sheriff's Department says they have some technology that can help. Action News reporter Robbie Kapoor is live outside the sheriff's office with more.
Well, Dan, it's called Project Lifesaver. It's a national effort turned local that intends to have those with mental disorders to keep them out of harm's way.
We had Coast Guard, CHP, Carmel Police Department, Monterey Police Department, USAR Search and Rescue, San Luis Obispo County Sheriff's Office, Santa Cruz Sheriff's Office, Santa Clara County Sheriff's Office, our Sheriff's Office. We had quite a few people this weekend.
More than 100 members of law enforcement and countless volunteers scoured through rough terrain in Monterey, Pacific Grove, and Pebble Beach looking for 82-year-old John Houseworth. It was the third time Houseworth went missing, and sheriff's deputies say a simple tracking device could have solved the case within minutes.
They leave. We can track them without their knowledge. It doesn't do anything physically to them. All it requires is this transmitter here.
The technology is part of a national effort called Project Lifesaver. The transmitter emits a tone using radio frequencies that the sheriff's department can triangulate to track down the missing person. When caregivers notify the sheriff's office, a search and rescue team is then sent to look for the person using a mobile tracking system.
In case he leaves, then he will be found in a short time.
77-year-old Lecanor Flores suffers from dementia and has been known to leave his house from time to time all alone. So when his wife Gloria heard about Project Lifesaver, they quickly signed up for it.
And we keep watch him. My family helps me, my grandkids and my children. But in case we miss it, at least we know that it will be easier to get some help.
For Flores and family, the device has added a tangible peace of mind at a price far lower than what it would take to find their loved one.
Look at the cost it took this weekend for 4 days of searching and over 100 people and stuff like that, compared to basically 300 start up and then, what is it, 300 a year? Yeah, big difference.
Now, the sheriff's office sends out this technology for $300 to initially start up and then $25 per month. And then each month, sheriff's deputies show up to your doorstep and actually change the transmitter's battery and check up on your health to see if there's any updates. They hope that this transmitter will preclude some such situations like we had this past weekend, and hopefully there'll be more happy endings overall. Dan?
And now hopefully more people know about it. Robbie, thank you. As for the equipment, they've got $10,000 worth of it paid for by an anonymous donor.